the time. So clap your hands. You can get out if you want to, but just make sure you maintain your social distancing. We're going to go ahead and get started.
The Lord with me. faithful. Not because I've been so good. You've always been there for me to provide my every need. You were there when I was lonely. You were there in all my pain. God in my footsteps, shelter from the rain, and it was you who made my life complete. You are to me my everything. That is why I sing. Jesus, I love you because you care. I couldn't imagine if you weren't there. Salvation, you're the peace in my storm. Loving arms protect me. You shelter me from harm. You are Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. My strong tower, my dearest and best friend. And Lord, it was you who made my life complete. You are Jesus, I love you.
Just one. they stretched him wide. He hung his head for me.
Anybody been to the
Anybody here been long? Anybody here been long? Anybody here been long? What Jesus told me, I'm free at last. Anybody free at last? Anybody free at last? Said I stepped in the water. Said I stepped in the water. Said I stepped in the water.
Verses, but I want you to read this entire chapter this week. Read this entire chapter. It's 26 verses, but I'm only going to read the first three. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Oh, give thanks to the God of gods, for his mercy endures forever. Oh, give thanks to the Lord of Lords, for his mercy endures forever. Thank you, Lord. Father, we just come before you right now, Lord God, and we just pray that as this word goes forth on today, that it will not fall on deaf ears, Lord God, but that your people would take the time to receive your word into their hearts, Lord God, and make a change for you. We pray, Lord God, that people will begin to thank you for your mercy that is never ending, God. We thank you right now, God, for those that are here to be able to hear this message. And God, we pray for those that will listen to it online, Lord God, that they will be blessed by the word on today. Father, we just thank you and we praise you right now. And I say, I submit my will to your will, God. Have your way. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I just want to talk to you for a few moments. This will be a very short message on grateful for God's mercy. Be grateful for God's mercy. This week, people will be busy preparing to celebrate Thanksgiving. But I want to remind you that while you are remembering the things that you are thankful for, do not forget the most important one, which is the Lord. It is my belief that people have gotten so caught up in paganism and commercialization of these holidays that they tend to forget to be grateful for God and what he has done for us. We need to express our gratitude to God, not just on Thanksgiving, but we should be grateful to him every day for his mercy. Back in 1978, Walter Hawkins and the Hawkins family released a song that we can take a lesson from today. Be grateful. See, listening to the words and then reflecting on your life can cause your heart to fill with gratitude. They said, God has not promised me sunshine. That's not the way it's going to be. But a little rain mixed with God's sunshine, a little pain makes me appreciate the good times. You know, if every day was a sunny day, we will begin to take it for granted and we'll start to feel like we're entitled to it. But there is a purpose, I want you to know, for the rainy days. The rainy days tend to bring a time of reflection for us. The rainy days cause you to look forward to brighter days. So the song goes on, and as it gets into a run of reasons to be grateful, and Lynette Hawkins, the sister, she said, because there's someone else, she told him, be grateful because there's someone else who's worse off than you. See, we tend to start to complain, you know. We find reasons to complain about this and complain about that. But don't you know, even on your worst day, you're better off than somebody else. There are people who are suffering way more than you. Then she goes on and she said, be grateful because there's someone else who would love to be in your shoes. I want you to know, while you're looking at your life and you're thinking, well, I wish I could be like this person, or I wish I could be in this position, or I had that, there's somebody who's looking at you and they're seeing what you have and they're saying, you know what, if I only had what they have. Be grateful for what you have. And then the last one that she said, and I wanted to point out, she said, be grateful because God said he would never, never forsake you. You know, we tend to get, again, caught up in our feelings and how we feel about things, and we forget that while we're going through, God is right there with us. He said that he would never leave us nor forsake us. He said he was with us always. So you should be grateful for God's mercy. And I love the way they end that song. She says, for it will be all right. So what I'm trying to get you to see today is that there is always something to be grateful for. In every situation, there is room to glorify God. And if we just look around, we have many, many reasons to praise his name. First of all, he woke you up this morning and you were able to open up your eyes and see. You were able to get out of bed and you could move around, and you might have been moving slow, but guess what? You were still moving. See, you might have had aches and pains, but you could still move around. You made it out to worship one more time, and I want you to think about it. You got a place to lay your head at night. You got food in your home, and you have electricity. All of this is because of God's mercy. See, we need to be grateful for God's mercy. If we look in our text, the psalmist Hezekiah wrote this, and he runs down a list of reasons to thank the Lord. And again, I said there's 26 verses, and each one closes with, his mercy endures forever. So I want to remind you today that we need to take the time to give God thanks. See, we should thank him for all that he does and all that he is. See, we need to thank him for being God and God alone. We need to thank him for being the Lord of all. We need to thank him for his love for us in spite of our faults. We need to thank God today for saving our souls. We need to thank him for his mercy toward us. And we need to thank him for his miraculous works. I want you to know that we need to thank him for moving in our lives. See, when things seem to be out of control in this world, we need to continue to put our trust in God and thank him that it could always be worse. But we can thank him knowing that everything that happens is subject to him and in his control. He created everything and he has the power to do anything. So I want to know, are you grateful today for God's mercy? He Hezekiah, he let us know that God does things through his mercy. He delivers his people. He saves his people. He separates his people for his purposes. He'll direct our paths. He'll lead us in the way we should go. God will defend us. He'll fight every battle. He'll be in there and he'll turn your enemy against, make them turn against each other. God will rescue us. Hezekiah, he said that God smote the firstborn of Egypt and brought Israel out of bondage. And then God delivered them from Pharaoh by allowing them to cross the Red Sea on dry land. God then vindicated Israel by drowning Pharaoh and his army. He said, this enemy you'll see no more. He then led the children of Israel through the wilderness, and he provided for their every need. All of this is because of God's mercy. God told Moses, I'll show mercy on whom I'll show mercy. So we need to be grateful today for God's mercy. how he supplied your needs. Remember every storm he brought you through. I don't know about you today, but I'm grateful for God's mercy. I could have been dead and gone, but God's mercy, it kept me. I could have lost my mind, but God's grace, it kept me. I've seen God move through impossible circumstances. I've seen God at work in my life. I've experienced his grace firsthand. How about you? Many of you have seen him work. You received some devastating news, but God turned it around. You had your heart broken, but God healed you. We had our share of ups and downs, but through it all, God has kept us, and by his grace and his mercy, we're still here today. Will you give God thanks for his grace and his mercy? Give God glory for his grace and his mercy. Are you grateful? Are you grateful? Are you thankful every day for what God has done for you? Give him glory. Give him glory. Give him glory. Give him glory. He deserves it. All the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. For God's mercy, we can't do nothing on our own. If it had not been for the Lord who was on our side, where would we be? I can tell you, I look back over my life, and all I can say is thank you, Lord, that you brought me from a mighty long way. Thank you, Lord, for the change that you made in my life. Thank you, God. We need to be grateful for God's mercy, because had he given us what we deserved, where would we be? Had he given us what we deserved, where would we be? None of us have a finger to point at anybody else, because we've all have a past. But it's because of God's grace and his mercy we are here today. Because of his grace and mercy, we're saved today. See, we couldn't save ourselves. And that's why I tell people all the time, stop trying to think that you're going to fix yourself up before you come to the Lord. We cannot fix ourselves. We can't change ourselves. But we can make a decision to follow Jesus Christ and allow him to do the work in us. I want to share this with you. Y'all know that I was in the military, and there was this one lady, one of the sergeants. She used to tell me all the time, I'm praying for you. I'd laugh. Yeah. Running off at the mouth. But she would always look at me and she would just say, I'm praying for you. Well, it won't too long after that, I ended up at a revival. And then I rededicated my life to the Lord. That lady shouted all over that church. She was in our unit, but her and one of the other girls went to that church. And my friend was the one that invited me to go to the revival. But I ended up, I don't even know how I got there, but from the back of the church, when I opened my eyes, I was in the front of the church. And that prayer that she prayed led me to surrender. That caused the change. I couldn't do it myself. So what I'm saying to you is that, first of all, those of you who know the Lord, don't stop praying for your loved ones, because God can change them. Then I'm saying to you who feel like you gotta wait till you get it right first, you'll never get it right. You just need to start getting with God. Come into his presence. When you come and you hear the word, that's how change takes place. That word will take a seat in your heart. And it might not happen the first few times you go. It might take you a little while, but I promise you, as that faith starts to get in your heart, the more you feed it, it will grow. And you'll be like me. You find yourself from sitting in your seat to standing at that altar. Could barely see through my tears. But I was like, I'm tired of the way I was living. So I want you to know that today, that all you have to do is just accept Jesus as Lord and Savior of your life. Put your trust in Him. Step number one, confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, and then you're saved. But after that, you need to get in some Bible teaching. You need to start reading the word. A lot of people say, well, I can't understand that these and thous and thuses. That's all right. New International Version, read straight English. Christian Standard Bible, read straight English. There are so many ways that you can get the Living Bible, read straight English. New Living Translation, there's so many ways. We have no excuses today. You have the Bible on your phone, or you can get it on your phone and allow it to, you can go to whatever version you want to see. You can compare versions. But get in some Bible teaching and make a change. Now, before I close out and let the worship team sing, in March, most of the country shut down because of coronavirus. A lot of people got sick and many have died. You still being here today is not by coincidence, nor is it of any of your own goodness, but it's by God's mercy. So I want you to start being grateful for every little thing and express your gratitude to the Lord, not just on Thanksgiving, where we say, I'm thankful for my family, I'm thankful for this. But I'm talking about every day. God, I just thank you for your grace and your mercy. I thank you, God, that I was able to get up. Somebody didn't get up this morning. Somebody woke up and couldn't move their body. So we got reason to thank God. Start thanking him every day that his mercy endures forever. Amen. Come on, worship team, and then we're going to have prayer after they sing this. Come on and let's give God glory and give him thanks. Yes. gonna ask you if you will, if you will step outside of your cars, those who can, if not, hold your, lift your hands, and let's give God glory. We're gonna pray for those who are going through things. If there's something that you're in need of on today, we're asking you to just lift your hands for it. We know that God is a gracious God. We know that God is a prayer answering God. And so today we may not be physically touching, but we are lifting our hands and we're touching and agreeing for God to move in our lives. Father, we just thank you right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, for every person that is gathered here today. God, every home that is represented. We're asking you right now, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, if you would just begin to touch, Lord God. Work out what needs to be worked out in the homes, Father. Move, Lord God. We ask you, God, to save those family members who need salvation. We ask you, God, to make ways, Lord God. Those who are struggling today, Lord God, we're asking you to send people to help them, God. Father, those who are sick in their bodies, we know, God, that your word said that by the stripes of Jesus we are healed. So we speak healing right now in the mighty name of Jesus. So God, we ask you right now to touch those, Lord God, who need touching in the mind, Father. Those who are dealing with anxiety and mental issues, Father. We know that just like you did the demoniac, God, and you healed him, Lord God, and you sent those demons out into the swine, and the man was able to go back and the people saw that he was well. We're speaking to those people today who are struggling with these mental illnesses, that you would touch them, Lord God, and you would deliver them from the demons that are attacking them. Father, we pray, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray for those who are lost today and do not know you, that somebody will begin to pray for them and somebody will witness to them of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you and we praise you right now. We pray, Lord God, for a hedge of protection around your people, Lord God. We ask you to let your angels encamp round about them to keep them safe, Lord God, as they go out, as they come in, Lord God. We ask them to be encircled in their angels. Father, we ask you to keep us, Lord God. Keep us safe, Father, like only you can, Lord. Lord, as we travel up and down the dangerous highways, we're asking you to let your angels encamp round about us. Let your blood cover us, Lord God, so that the demon, the devil would have to pass over, Lord God. We thank you, God, right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, God, we thank you for your love. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy that is new every day, Lord God. Great is your faithfulness, God. Help us, oh God, to continue to put our trust in you. No matter what it looks like, we got to trust you. Oh God, we just thank you and we glorify you and we magnify you. God, we just say thank you. Thank you for loving us when we were unlovable. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, God, for just being God. We love you, God, and we thank you and we praise you. It's in Jesus' name. Now, Father, as we leave this place, we ask you right now, Lord, to let us arrive at our next destination and find everything well.